Townies was a sitcom about Boston.
About Massachusetts. Yeah, Massachusetts, but there's like the shore.
Right.
Yeah, you're good.
Yeah, that was...
Only here for one season.
Yeah.
I played Jenna Elfman's boyfriend.
Your upper body wasn't moving. I don't think that'll be a problem.
You stressed out?
No, but... You know, I'm an amateur.
Everybody's an amateur. Seeing people on the news that are getting interviewed for the first time?
Mm-mm.
Huh?
Have I?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Is it going? Okay, so tell me you were holding out before. What was the...
About what?
Sorry. It's on the wrong side. Okay. No, okay. This time. Excuse me.
So what do you want me to... What were you saying?
What were you saying before?
About what?
About, I said that I heard that that daddy never told you that his parents were deaf. That either you found out from some, how did you find out?
My neighborhood friend that we used to double date, and he mentioned it to me, that's what he thought. And I don't know if it's because when he telephoned, he always got, you know, I don't know.
So what did your neighborhood friend?
What about him?
Tell me what about him? He thought what?
Well, he just mentioned that.
Mentioned what?
That he thought his parents were deaf. But he didn't say why he thought. Maybe he had been over to the house. I don't know.
So did you ever ask Daddy why he didn't tell you? Did you ask him? How did you find out?
I don't think we talked about it. I don't, David, that was so long ago, I don't remember. I don't know.
So what was the first time you realized? How did you find, you don't know how you found out?
No.
It wasn't a big deal?
Mm-mm. I was just supposed to understand it. Mm-mm.
So do you think, I guess that's what I was wanting to ask before, how do you think that kind of communication, do you think that was your family like his family, I guess?
Well, we didn't have anything to hide, I guess. And whether it was hidden or not, I don't know. But I think our family probably was more open. Is that a good enough answer? Are you going to ask him some of these questions too? Will you let me know what he what he says?
I think you're more open than him.
He probably doesn't even remember. Probably, you know, won't even think it was important. Or maybe he was so used to it, he didn't think it was anything that should be discussed. I don't know. I'll be interested to hear.
So,
maybe also when he saw his brother drowned, may have had some kind of an effect. You never know.
Why did I remember the story that that Daddy was drowning and his brother jumped in to save him?
I don't know. I don't know, but I know he learned how to swim. You know, he was a swimmer. He was in swimming meets all because of that. I think that is part of why he became a swimmer. But I don't know, David. I don't know that I remember anything like that.
How do you think growing up with deaf parents would affect somebody?
Well, they have a little bit more responsibility, a different responsibility than other kids. For one thing, it's a pretty quiet house. I mean, there were probably no radios or anything until the children were able to buy them themselves. That's something that maybe you have to ask somebody who grew up that way.
How do you think it's different? How do you think it would be different now growing up in a deaf family versus 80 years ago?
Well, I think they may enjoy television. I mean, his mother would. She could read the lips and know a little bit what was going on. You know, a lot of deaf people drove cars. They didn't. I don't know.
What other gadgets do you remember around his family's house?
That's the only one I really remember.
Did they have a doorbell?
I don't know. I don't know. When I first met them, they lived in a house, and then they moved into an apartment that was, you know, a whole row of houses. I mean, apartments, all one story. So, I don't know. His dad walked to work. Well, she must have too, because they didn't live too far from Goodyear. Some of their friends had cars. They never had one.
How, and what other ways do you think your family was different from his family?
They had three boys and we had four girls and one boy. It's one difference.
What what's your biggest accomplishment?
Probably having 5 children, healthy children, good-looking children, beautiful children. And reaching 80, both of my parents died in there. Well, my mother was like 78, and my father was, he wasn't even 70, I don't think.
Okay, now you can only pick one for each child. What is Lynn's best quality?
Lynn's best quality. David, this is hard to do. He's a good mother and a good wife. That's two.
Okay. What's Karen's best quality?
I could make it easy by saying the same thing. Karen can be lighthearted and funny, plus being a good mother and a good wife.
What about Gail's best quality?
Well, when you see her with her child and her dogs, she's loving and intelligent and has helped the world just with her job working with children, you know, that had speech defects or whatever.
What's my best quality?
You're so hardworking and loving and handsome and...
Just one.
Oh, I can't think of just one.
What's Amy's best quality?
Amy's best quality. Well, she's hardworking, keeps plugging along, and striving for what she wants. And she, you know, she needs to find a good job and a good husband and all of that.
What is, can you do an imitation of each of your kids? You did a good imitation of Lynn once before.
I did?
Yeah.
I don't think I
no?
can, David.
Okay. Okay, what's your scariest moment?
It wasn't a scary moment, but that month on a ship going, driving to Brooklyn, and with Antonine drove me to Brooklyn with Lynn, who was not 5 yet, and Karen, who was 18 months, getting on a ship with 350 other mothers and children, going through the Panama Canal, which was pretty exciting, landing in San Francisco, and then going to Japan. It took 30 days. And every time there was a drill, we'd have to put life jackets on Lynn and Karen and me, and then we'd have to go up the ladder, me holding Karen. And it was a long 30 days. And being seasick half of the time. So it was quite an experience. But it wasn't scary.
So it wasn't your scariest moment?
No.
Okay.
I had 5 scary moments on the way to the hospital. And you were born in Beirut. That was pretty exciting.
Do you think, what about Gail? I mean, Gail went into something working with hearing and speech impaired people. Do you think that had anything to do with grandma, grandpa, or was that just a lark?
I don't know. I think you'd have to ask her.
I'm asking you.
Well, I don't know what her thoughts were. I think it was something that was just offered when she, you know, I really don't know why, how she went into it. But she worked how many years? 30 years, 25 years doing it, so.
Okay.
Have I told all the funny stories that you want me to tell?
No, I mean, I just was wanted to find out stuff about Grandma and Grandpa, but I also wanted you to talk about other stuff first so you'd feel more comfortable by the time you got to Grandma and Grandpa. Do you?
Well, haven't you finished talking about them?
Do you feel more comfortable?
Probably. What about my mother and father?
What
they were her grandmas and grandpas.
Okay. Well, I was asking.
Yeah.
I asked about them. Didn't
right.
Did you get? Is there anything else you want to tell me?
I don't think so. I can't think. Well, I told you about the four girls sleeping in one room. Two to a bed, and you know, we had one pair of shoes. We didn't have what the kids have nowadays, and but we were happy. We didn't know any better. Everybody was in the same boat.
About what you used to go to Canada when you were a kid? Did you go often?
A few times. No, we never had a car, so we always had. If somebody asked us to go, then we'd get a ride with somebody, but I went enough times that, you know, I remember what it was like up there. But my mother's sister and her husband had one child, and he hated to put too many people in his car because he was afraid the springs would break, if you can imagine that. So, you know, there were five children in our family, so we didn't get rides very often with anybody. I grew up in Akron. I never knew how beautiful the state of Ohio was because I never saw it until, the girls started going to college in Athens, and you know, Ohio is a pretty state. All I ever knew was Akron and Cleveland sometimes, because my one aunt lived in Cleveland for a while.
Do you remember the first time you left the country? Like left the main, Canada, North America? Do you remember your first impressions? That was when, where, Japan?
Yeah. The impression?
Your first impressions.
Of leaving?
And being over there.
Oh, and being in Japan? Well, one thing, we lived on a base. It was all Americans, so we didn't live right in the city, so it wasn't quite like other places we lived, you know.
What was your favorite country overseas that you lived in?
Probably Beirut, I guess.
Tell me about it.
Well, we lived at the end of a tram line on a busy street. AUB was on that street, and we were down at the end, and we were in, they called it the first floor, but it was one floor up, you know, from the street. But that's where the trams switched, and our bedroom was right at the front of the apartment, so that we heard, I mean, after a while you didn't hear it, but at first it was terrible because in the middle of the night you'd hear all this squeak, 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 squeak as they were switching. But we used to swim there. I could walk down to the beach. I couldn't drive in any of these. In Jordan I could drive, but Saudi Arabia I couldn't drive. And in Beirut I guess I could have, but I didn't have I didn't drive in Beirut. So,
You drove in Morocco.
Yeah.
So, okay. That's it.
Were women not allowed to drive in Saudi Arabia?
Mm-mm. Now, out in the desert, the desert Bedouins, they drive trucks and everything out there, but, couldn't drive, couldn't, I didn't, I wore long dresses with long sleeves, but I didn't cover my head or anything, but it was a different life. Probably changing a little bit now. I'd always have to ask for money. You know, there was no bank or anything that I could go to. I mean, there were banks, but anyway, it was 8 years over there, so I should get a ribbon for that.
What else should you get a ribbon for?
Well, having such nice children. And, I don't know, just, we're not being interviewed now, are we? Oh, we are?
Yeah, it's been on the whole time.
Oh, I thought it was over. now I'm speechless again.
I know. Okay, that's good, Mom. That's good. Yeah, part of my notes was to leave the camera on when you didn't know it was on.
Ah.
So. Can we do a couple shots of, like, I'll show you a couple things.
Oh, sure.
or look at...
Nope.
Huh?
Just wait till he says he's ready.
I'm ready.
Okay, so just cut a bouquet for yourself.